So this will be my sixth video covering parallel sun rays and the problems on the globe. That was my first one. Number two, this is a couple years back. And there's number three and four. There's number five. And so I'm going to point out the problems with parallel sun rays on a globe. Okay, the latitudes are parallel. We see them on a globe. They're called parallels. But when we're facing due east on equinox, there's 30 degrees north. And there's the equator, and then there's 30 degrees south. This is the direction we are looking at on a globe. So if you pointed, so locally, it looks like you're looking along the latitude. But that's not the ultimate direction you're pointing to. You're pointing toward the equator. Or if you shot a laser due east at 30 north or 30 south, your laser is going to wind up above the equator. So if I'm at 30 north looking due east, there's the direction I'm looking in. From the equator, there's the direction I'm looking. From 30 south, there's the direction I'm looking. That is not parallel. That is converging. So if I've got a God view of the Earth, there would be parallel lines. So the sun's rays would have to follow the latitudes, but they don't.
So that's Brian, and he thinks that the sun's rays can't be parallel because of, converging surface lines. I can only conclude that he thinks that the sun has to be situated on the surface of the Earth and its light rays can somehow magically bend around the world. This is the sixth video he's made on this subject, and I'm certain that he's been told countless times that the surface lines he makes in the direction of the sunrise are not lines of sight to a distant point that is out in space. So this video should ensure that there won't be a part 7 from Brian, because I'm going to demolish all his talking points with geometry. And if he still can't see the light at the end of all of this, well, there's just no helping him. Now, for me to demo this, I feel it's important for me to go through and say what each line does. So we'll start off with this lowercase r, and this is the radius value for the Earth, and it's in kilometres. This is our sphere. It's centred at the origin with radius r. That's quite straightforward. The longitude and latitudes. These look a little bit complicated, but essentially they're just drawing circles. The longitudes are spaced at 30 degrees. The latitudes are spaced at 15 degrees. The equator is a straightforward circle. That's this one. P, this is a sequence of points that will represent our observers. They're all spaced at 15 degrees as well, so that they sit on the latitude lines. And they're all sitting on a meridian, which is 90 degrees west. Point 1 is at the North Pole. This will be point 2, and so on, all the way around to the South Pole. This will be point 13. So point 5 here, this is what we're on. This is 30 degrees north. This will be point 7 at the equator. Point 9 will be 30 degrees south. We can't see the GP of the sun just yet because it's underneath this sun point here. This is point S, and S has a distance from the centre of the Earth which is 1.5 times 10 to the power of whatever this slider is. So if I move the sun away vertically, we can now see the GP. You'll notice that this segment appeared. This is lowercase s, so that's a segment from the GP to the sun. This slider here, this has a role to play in how the great circle is drawn, which is this black circle, and how the red arc, the surface path, is drawn. So if I was to move this to 9, we can see it's now 30 degrees south. I could go all the way up to the North Pole or all the way down to the South Pole with it. We'll leave it on 30 degrees north for now. Before we look at the last two lines, we'll look at these two views here. This is just simple text. We have a meridian view, and we also have a central view. The central view just focuses on the midpoint of this red arc. We can also center on the sun by clicking on this checkbox. And remember that the sun distance is dependent on this slider, and this goes all the way up to number 8. So that would be 1.5 times 10 to the power of 8, or 150 million kilometers. So let's slide that over and see how that looks. We'll go a bit closer first of all. We can see the X, the Y, and the Z axis. We move away. And that should take us all the way up to 150 million kilometers, which it does. And that is reflected up here. Let's take us back. So what I've been building up to is this last line, which is the rays sequence. And what this sequence will do is it will create segments from point S to each point in 10. So that will be a segment from here to point 1, to point 2, and so on, all the way around to point 13. And when it draws these segments in, it won't care if the segments have to travel through the Earth to get to these points. So if we just focus on this outside segment that goes to point 1, the solid part is the part that's outside of the sphere, and the dashed part is the part that's inside of the sphere. The question is now is, what will these rays look like if we start to move the sun away? So let's do that. We'll see that the segments get tighter and tighter together the further we move away. And if we go all the way to 150 million kilometers away, it just looks like one sunbeam. Let's go all the way back. This time we'll center on the Earth. We'll do that again. This is the sun end at 150 million kilometers away, back at the Earth. And you could ask what role these surface lines play in all of this. And the answer is not much, other than the fact that they all cross the equator where the GP is. And have you noticed that all these lines look pretty parallel? Let's give it a roll around and have a look. Yeah, they all sit pretty nicely. Yeah, should we center on the meridian? See what that looks like. Oh, blimey. Look at that. Who'd have thought that? That they all line up with each latitude line.
So if I'm at 30 north, looking due east, there's the direction I'm looking. From the equator, there's the direction I'm looking. From 30 south, there's the direction I'm looking. That is not parallel. That is converging.
For this observer, the sun can be seen with a straight line of sight. This is the direction they're looking, and it's to a distant point out in space. However, this red surface path is simply that. It's just the path that will take the observer to a place where the sun can be viewed directly overhead. They can't look along the entirety of that path for the same reason ships disappear bottom up as they sail out to sea.
My point is, I've got these little bubblegum men with their arms pointing 90 degrees, okay? See where their arms are pointing? So, that little red piece of tape will be the sun, okay? So we're the observers, okay? We're all pointing and looking due east. Now we're waiting on the sun to come up, okay? I've got a black line right beside the pink line highlighted, our line of sight, our great circle. Okay, now just if I raise it off the ground, okay, that angle's not gonna change. Look, I'm gonna raise it, so we're right here waiting for the sun to come up. Sun comes up, okay? It's still converging, and look, oh shit.
That's it for this one. If you enjoyed it, please hit that like button for me and let me know down below if you think this will make the slightest bit of difference to Brian's way of thinking. Catch you later.